Boys and girls, to another episode of What I Watched This Month, February Edition. I kicked off the month with watching Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. The way the movie was animated was different than any animation I've ever watched. The sound effects, and it just felt so good. The movie was impeccable. I cried when he finally found that leap of faith. It got me into a roller coaster of emotions, but it will not surpass. Okay man, enough with the Shrek jokes. I followed it then by watching Ragnarok, a Norway production. It had very cold tempo, very cold jokes, and definitely annoyed me with environment and climate change awareness. But if they drop a new season, I will watch it, since I have no life. Then I watched Jojo Rabbit, directed by Taika Waititi. This guy knows how to tell a story in a movie, and also how he mixes different forms of art, dancing, drawing, you name it. Huge appreciation to Scarlett Johansson for her role as Jojo's mom. Every time she was with him, I smiled like this. I also watched The Birds of Prey and blah blah blah. Well, it was more of Harley Quinn movie, but totally ruined everything at the final scene. Anyways, you make another Harley Quinn, amen. Then I watched BoJack Horseman and felt miserable for a week. This series showed the secrets of Hollywood from the perspective of BoJack, who was famous for his TV show, then became controversial since he deals with his childhood issues, drinking issues, and also depression. I highly recommend it to those who are really into Hollywood things. Next, I watched All the Boys I Love. Okay, pass. I watched Lock and Key as well. It was amusing and funny and romantic, full of magic keys, until one point I wished I had one of those keys to put the idea of us in my crush's mind. Then I watched Marriage Story, and oh did I love it. I kept waiting for Charlie's scene in the restaurant where he's becoming alive after his divorce with Nicole. Calm down, I did not spoil anything. Relax. Then I watched Jojo Rabbit again, and I cried again. After that, I watched Parasite, the big Korean hit. If you're into cars flying and action, this movie is not for you. The movie treated the subject of social inequality from another perspective. The more you look deeper into details and learn just a bit about poverty in South Korea, you will definitely enjoy it and name it a masterpiece. Then I watched Knives Out, starring a lot of stars. This is a thriller movie that follows the investigation of Harlan Thrombey's mysterious death. This movie gave us 2 hours of confusion and mind games, and one not expected plot twist, and might not blow your mind as well if you watch a lot of thriller. Then I watched SpongeBob SquarePants. Hooray, SpongeBob! That was my impression for Patrick. And oh my god, I enjoyed it a lot. It is one of those gems that should live forever. And I proudly announce officially that I am a goofy goober. Then I watched The Simpsons movie as well. I missed a lot of jokes when I watched it before. I enjoyed it so much, and it has a very dark humor. Then I continued discovering Netflix new hits, and this time I am not okay with this. What a powerful chemistry between Sydney and Stanley. The plot follows a teen girl who struggles with her superpowers when she's mad. Although it lacked a lot of depth, it was so beautiful and amazing. And also it's super easy to watch. 7 episode with 20 minutes each. Come on. Then I watched Peaky Blinders season 5. I must say that adding Sam Clavin was a great touch. He was attractive and gave us some amazing monologues, since this season marked the beginning of the fascism movement. Then I watched Jojo Rabbit again, and I'm making it a monthly thing. Then I watched John Mulaney and Sakalak Bunch. Since I love musicals, I enjoyed it a lot. And if I ever felt bored, I might watch it again. I followed it by watching Toy Story 4. The ending of this amazing animation saga was a piece of art, and it has always been since they dropped the first part. I'm gonna miss Sheriff Woody, Buzz Lightyear, and everyone that's made it an amazing journey. I watched as well Kafar Nahum by Nadine Labaki. The movie is so sad. It was painful to watch, since you get so emotional because you see a poor family that struggles to raise their children, married at young age, abusing women, taking advantage of others, and how poverty can make you give up all of your principles. Last but not least, I watched Ferris Bueller's Day Off. It carries a message of not beating yourself up. Do everything but live a little. And also, don't put yourself into a lot of pressure like his friend Cameron Frye, who is scared and depressed, while Ferris Bueller is the coolest dude you will ever see on a movie. Finally, I watched Sausage Party. That was very sarcastic and full of nasty jokes. This animation was created by Jonah Hill, Seth Rogen, and the rest of the crazy crew. I mean, just these names will make you motivated to watch it. That was everything for this month. Hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think in the comments, and what movie/series do you recommend. Until then, see you next month.
Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.